real good to be here with you, and I hope you'll enjoy some of the old time, what they call bluegrass music. Old time style. I was here with my brother Carter in England in 1966. It's been about 25 years. We played over in London at the Royal Albert Hall over there and had a good time. We spent about 21 days in Europe. Of course, we played three or four shows in England, went to Germany, Switzerland, Sweden, Denmark, and places like that. Had a good time. It's good to be with you. Hope you enjoy it. To the Clinch Mountain Boys as they come up to play for you. We're going to call on the young man over on one of the guitars. In 1966, he had never been heard of. He's my son. He's 12 years old. Soon will be 13. And girls, he's never been married. Of course, there's not too much difference in murdered and married. Get murdered, you're gone real quick. And if you get married, you sort of ooze out. Well, Stanley the Second, nice hand for it. Jack Cooke and the Footprints in the Snow. You know about all the numbers that you hear us do while we have them on a tape or a record or something like that. So we have that one, I guess. You got that with you?
No.
I'm supposed to say it.
Stanley! Stop that, bro!
Do what?
Stop Stanley! Make some sandwiches in Monroe.
Okay. Now we'd like to introduce you to our lead guitar player. He's from the great state of Kentucky. Make welcome Hank Smith, the knife hand.
Hey! He's traveled all around the world playing this music. And in 1984, he was presented with an award by the President of the United States, Ronald Reagan, called the National Heritage Award. He's one of the only bluegrass artists ever to receive it. He's traveled all around the United States and many foreign lands, made 3 trips to Japan. This is about his 3rd trip in England. So if you folks would, make him welcome here in England, Dr. Ralph Stanley.
Yeah.
No, I may not be able to walk.
I can't.
I may not be able to talk.
I can't.
I may not be able to
preach.
Oh.
three with the Hebrew children, two with the falling Silas, one with the little baby, one children born to Bethlehem. Children go where to send
me. Oh, Lordy,
how will I send thee? Oh, I'm gonna send thee four that stood at the door, three with the Hebrew children, two with the falling Silas, one with the little baby, one children born in Bethlehem. Children go where to send
thee. Oh, Lordy,
how will I send thee? Oh, I'm gonna send thee ten, by ten for the ten for the ten commandments, nine for the nine that stood in the line, eight for the eight that waited at the gate, seven for the seven that never come to heaven, six for the six that didn't get fit, four for the five that come back alive, four for the four that stood at the door, three for the Hebrew children, two for the boy in silence, one was a little bitty baby, I missed anybody?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Folks, that old man over there with the fiddle. Has been with me 25 years. He's got some with me, and he's got some with him and me together. And that's called Like Father, Like Son. And we're going to, Jack Cooke has got Ralph Stanley and Flinch Mountain Lord. You got any by the Stanley Brothers?
Not one CD, Ralph. One CD by the Stanley Brothers.
Not one CD by the Stanley Brothers. And folks, you know, Ricky Skaggs and Keith Whitley both got their start with me. And we recorded a live tape in Camp Springs, North Carolina in 1971 with Keith Whitley doing all the lead singing and Ricky Skaggs doing the mandolin play and some twin fiddling of Ray and doing some high tenor. And we've got that for sale. We've got an all claw hammer that my mother taught me to play. And we've got a picture of her on the tape. That picture was made in 1912. She was 26 years old. And she's a whole little banjo that she taught me to play. We got a few of them. And you got any of the live farm in front of
16 years.
Got one of 16 years. No, we didn't have room to bring a lot of things. And they're very limited, so I guess the first come, first serve. After the show, well, we hope to have some light back there and give you a chance as you go out, maybe to look over to them. And, this banjo, we carry a flea market along with us. This banjo is a Stanley tone, and it was designed by me and built by a fellow in Kentucky by Frank D. And I built 100 of them. And this one is the last one I have left of the 100. It's for sale. All that I ask is to let me play it from now, tomorrow, and Sunday. And I'll be willing to turn it over to you. Curly Ray Cline has got number 3. He's already been offered $12,000 for it. It won't cost you near that much. I'm not going to tell you how much, but go back and see Ernie. Ernie Thacker, and he'll tell you about it. But I'll tell you one thing. By the time that Arthur, where's Arthur sitting there?
Where you at, Arthur?
The time that Arthur is as old as Curly Ray Cline, I'd say this banjo will bring from $50,000 to $100,000. I don't know how many pounds that is, but it'll be a collector's item. You can get it. See Ernie after the show. If you don't want it tonight, we'll have it tomorrow and we'll have it Sunday unless we sell it. Now here's Ralph II, the new goes like this.
Right in the pan.
Oh,
they throw me
down
from the hand.
Down, 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 down.
From the ivory, from the pan.
Oh,
gonna run me off. Maggie Muley was!
Folks, I believe around the 15th of October, maybe the 16th, 1946, Brother Carter, Stanley, and me started this band, known as the Stanley Brothers and the Prince Mountain Boys. We traveled together for 20 years. We toured about 46 of the United States and, of course, several of the other countries, like England, Germany, Switzerland, Sweden, Denmark. We recorded over 100 long-play albums. December the 1st, 1966, Brother Carter passed away. And since that time, I've done my very best to keep the same sound that two little barefoot boys from the hills of Virginia brought out to the world. And about 2 years after Carter died, I wrote a tribute to Carter. We'd like to do it for you now. We hope you'll enjoy the hills of home. as I can, like my mother told me.
Pretty well.